I kill, I don't save anymore. Smashing.
Hello everybody, it's your old pal Slow Smashing with another fantastic tale, Smashing and Bashing.
It's Slow Motion.
And then this tale, ow, 2-for-1, merciless build-up figure, yeah, Batman and Superman.
Alright, so let's take a look at the front of the packaging right here. Batman, Superman. Yeah, it's a front view with the merciless stems in there. And then all their accessories, you can see. Let's take out the side view right there. Batman, Dark Knight's metal, Superman. And in the back right there, you got all the missing pieces that you need to make the merciless. Cool photo, the Savage Batman and Savage Superman right here, and some other figs in the line that you need to create the merciless. Take a look at the other sides of it. Superman, Infected, and then Batman.
Alright, so let's get these guys cracking and smashing with the quickity quickness now.
But otherwise, let's just go ahead and quickity quickie. Alright, so here they are halfway out of their boxes. Alright, there they are standing on their own 2 feet right there. This Infected Superman, a Savage Dark Metal, Dark Knight Metal Batman right there. And all the things that come with right here. Start off with Batman right here. Of course, these are a Build-A-Figure for the Merciless. You get the arms with Batman. And then look at this Batman. The reason why they entice me to this Batman, besides looking cool, is that this Batman is savage. He's like serious. He inflicts wounds. Batman doesn't do that. Use lethal force. This Batman does. Look at these bat axes right here. All these cool, like, chiseled marks right here and, like, withered looks. I mean, I'm surprised there's not, like, blood on here right here. It looked pretty cool. The fact that he's using these crazy axes to against his foes is just that makes that Batman cooler. Look at Superman right here. We're gonna look at his merciless features right here, or his parts right here. You get the legs. And otherwise with the Infected Superman, you just get alternate hands right here, which I'm definitely gonna put one of these open hands on there. I mean, look at that. You could tell he's all twisted up the way he's just using his fingers. I mean, look at his face right there, right? Otherwise, let's just go ahead and check out. No. Start off with Batman right here. Look at this Savage Batman. Even his picture right there, he got like blood coming out of his mouth. He's just all like savage and crazy looking. Look at that face right there. Look, he's not messing around. He's like in it to kill it. Just like all the texturing was cool. And you know, at first I thought there's this texturing on his suit right here in a detail, but you know, there's actual like battle wounds, like battle marks right here. Like he's been slashed and everything. Like he's been in combat, just like not messing around right there. But he just got that like hard chiseled face right there, and like he got that blocky looking bat like mask right there. Grays and blacks, so he got that gray costume look going there. And looking like the texturing on his boots is cool on the back right here. Got like a soft cape. The cape even looks kind of tattered up and torn, like I was showing on the uniform right there. And he could popped out right all these muscles right there. And then also like texturing from like the woven materials in his suit right there look cool. And his bat belt right there, the yellows, and then the fins are cool, and that same texturing like on the boots, like are on his gauntlets right there. Overall just a cool look. I like the bat symbol right there, yellows and grays and blacks. And then on to the Infected Superman. You know, this is the one that I really wanted. This guy's just awesome. I had to have one. I saw him. Look at his arms. He's just all twisted. Look at his face right there. Look at that face. You can tell the Superman is not in it to save. He's out there just the nefarious like task and stuff. He's gonna do some twisted like stuff and like photos upcoming on Slow Smashing here. Look at that. Even like the costume right here, this looks like it's just like not a good Superman right there. He gets like a blue purple looking suit right there. It looks cool. Even maybe some like white pearl in there, looks tight. His reds are even darker, more like a crimson color. And then his like skin is just like he's like zombie-ish looking right there. And I think going back right here, looking at his cape, it's all tattered up and torn even more than Batman's. Like you really could tell this guy's all drooping down too. Like he's just letting his costume go on the back. He gets pretty good muscle striations. Let's say Batman had more muscle striations on, especially on the legs and stuff. But this guy's cool too. He's clean, but I mean it's just really the upper part of detailing is where this guy shines, especially that face. Alright, so let's get into articulation. We'll start with the bat right here.
I kill, I don't save anymore.
But look at it, we'll start with his head. So his head right here is weird. Can you see that little line right there? I thought his head separated motion from like that big old thick stout neck right there, but the neck is pretty much the motion for his head right there. It doesn't really move like anywhere else on his head, but the neck is pretty good. He's like,
hey, I listen to heavy metal.
And it moves left and right, and yes, yeah, it does do yes and no. It's like,
heavy metal.
But moving down to his arms right there, he gets those, the McFarlanes are cool because they got those little like mini butterfly joints right there, and it aids with the motion. It's not like as good as some other butterflies, but it works. Look at this tight. There we go. Click, click, click. You hear that? But you can do some chicken flapping right there, forward and backwards. It got some bicep swivel right there, and the double joints in the arms right there work pretty good. And then we go to see if he has a forearm swivel. No forearm swivel. The other point of motion is going to be his wrist. His hand swivels around, it hinges up and down, but it's hindered because he got that thick gauntlet right there. Other bat arm is going to do the same thing, and it's just as tight right there. You know, you got to be careful sometimes because they've been known to break these figures when moving them. So his ab crunch is pretty cool. Crunches pretty good, and it swivels. And even he has a bottom like waist swivel right there, and that helps too. It's a little tight, but look at that. Pretty cool when you use both of them together. I like it. I dig it. Going to his legs right here. Look at his legs. He got those bat push kicks. You know, and that's one thing I've noticed that some of these, I don't know if all the DC Multiverse have them, but they have like these joints right here. I'm not a big fan of those joints right there because I've had them break on me and just separate and they don't go back on, and it sucks. But anyways, otherwise, like push kicking action is pretty good. Side kicking action is definitely good with these joints because you see that's their specialty right there, doing a split. Down, no thigh swivel, down to the knee, got like a double joint knee that works good. No calf swivel, that would have been cool, but he does go down to the ankles right here, and that swivels all the way around, pivots, and it goes up and down. Not much again because of the shin thing. And then he has a toe, a hinge right there, so it articulates. And then the other bat leg does the same thing when Batman kills. You know, I just thought of a cool name for him. They got like the Batman Who Laughs, like right there. Or the Bat Who Laughs. Or just the Batman Who Laughs, Batman Who Laughs. They should have the Bat Who Kills. Anyway, to the coolness of this Superman. Man, this guy's just so awesome right here. Look at this. Let's go with his articulation. It goes left and right. I mean, it just goes all over the place. Look at that. Look at that sinister look. Right? His head will move all over the place. His arm. His arm has that same kind of like butterfly joint as Batman head. And it aids with the front and back motion. It goes forward and backwards and it flaps. This one was easy. It's super easy. It's just nice and broken. Whereas that guy was just stiff. Stiff. And his bicep swivel, it moves. I'll probably move all the way. His muscles kind of get in a way, you know. But then double joints right there work good too for his elbows right there. They go down to his big old like fist right there. They swivel and they hinge up and down and they give you good motion right there. The other infected Superman arm does the same thing right here. And then to his ab crunch, he has a similar ab crunch as a bat. Works pretty good, like it. And then the bottom one, let's see. Yeah, the bottom one's pretty much the same too. It just needs to be worked out more. It's a little tight. Forward joints, moving forward with the legs right there. He kind of like struggles to get those push kicks up. Side kicking action's good. And then, yeah, he does have those same leg joints right there. It's like, well, hopefully they stay together and do their job. Do your job, pay your bills. Down to his knees right here. Look at that double joints in action right there. They work good, just like the other bat. No thigh swivel. And then the ankle swivel is going to be the same. Swivels all the way around, pivots, and then up and down. And we got like a toe hinge too, which looks ugly when you put it up. I mean, look at that. It's not ugly. Other leg does the same thing. Alright, Batman got those Viking axes right there ready to like kill and take lives and not save them. Let's bust out the tape right here, see how tall these guys are right here. Superman, he's just over 7 inches, a few ticks above. And Batman, wow, Batman's actually taller. He's like closer to 7.5 inches. Why is Batman taller than Superman now? I thought it would be the other way around. That's, I'm like a wheel. You'd be the judge. All right, there he is to another DC Multiverse Superman right there. All right, and there they are next to the Ben Affleck SH Figure Arts Batman. And there they are all stacked up together. All right.
right, so what about this box? We don't want this box. This box is getting smashed. Alright, so since there's two of them, let's get them stacked up like Oreo cookies right here. Fist of smash.
Alright, so let's wrap up the tale with these two guys. The bat who kills right here is really cool, and then the infected Superman, man. This guy's cool. I dig them both. But y'all let me know what you think about them downstairs in the comments below. Until the next tale, smash your bell, smash your thumb, subscribe if you haven't had to already, because we are the bat killing, bat Superman smashing out.